Hello everyone, welcome once again in the online lectures, and we are talking about retrosynthesis as well as synthesis of natural product, and in which we are discussing about the retrosynthesis of strychnine. In the last lecture we discussed about the retrosynthesis of strychnine, in which it gives a 22 to 24 different products in the retrosynthesis. Now in this lecture we will be discuss about the total synthesis of this strychnine. We know that in the last lecture, if you go for the retrosynthesis, the final starting materials will be used as a phenylhydrazine as well as acetoveratrol. Then we can start the synthesis from the phenylhydrazine as well as the acetoveratrol. We know that the structure of this phenylhydrazine is like this. NH2, so this is phenylhydrazine, and from this phenylhydrazine as well as from the acetoveratrol we can start the synthesis of the strychnine. In the acetoveratrol the molecule will be like this. It containing a aromatic benzene ring as well as a 2 methoxy group and 1 ketone group, that is ME. So it is called as an acetoveratrol. Then we can use this starting material by using a Fischer-Indol synthesis. That means in Fischer-Indol synthesis, by using a polyphosphoric acid, we can synthesize the indol. And if we see its mechanism, it can be shown initially the NH2 group of this phenylhydrazine will be combined with this carbamyl group, and then it gives formation of a compound like this. Here is NH, then it will be combined with the carbamyl group and it gives formation of a imine with formation of compound like this, right? So this is the compound which is formed after the condensation by using polyphosphoric acid. Then in the next step, so it gives formation of a enamine. That means it is a reversible reaction, and then it gives formation of a enamine, and then enamine will be like this. Here it gives a formation of double bond, and then remaining group will be same. It is OME, right? And it is again a aromatic ring like this. Then in the next step, the lone pair of this nitrogen will be shifting here, and then it gives a rearrangement compound, and after that rearrangement it gives a compound like this. That means here it is a aromatic ring, right? Then it will be combined with this methyl group, and here the NH double bond is formed, and here the remaining functionalities will be same, that is OME. There is a hydrogen, there is formation of double bond NH, and then in the next step it undergoes aromatization, and then after aromatization it gives compound like this. There is double bond, and then remaining aromatic ring will be same here. It containing a OME function group, and here is a NH2 group is there, and then it gives a formation of such type of aromatized compound. Then in next step, from polyphosphoric acid it will be takes proton, and then it gives formation of a quaternary ammonium salt. It is again a reversible reaction, and after that it gives formation of a compound like this. It having a functionalities will be same, that is OME. Then it having these aromatic ring, and then in the next step the NH2 group will be attack on this carbon-carbon double bond, and then it gives a cyclized compound, and this cyclized compound will be used a 5 member ring and these five membering will be like this, and then here is the another aromatic ring which containing a OMe and OMe function group will be same. Then it gives formation of NH2 here. Here is NH2 plus, right? So this is the first mechanism where we can see that Fischer-Indol synthesis, and after that it will be removes the ammonia gas from the reaction. After that it again gives AH plus ion, and then it gives formation of a 2-veratryl indole. And if you see the structure of this 2-veratryl indole, the structure will be like this. It having a functionalities, that is, here is OME, here is OME in this way, and here is a double bond. That means it gives a alpha beta unsaturated cysteine, and the name of this compound is 2-veratryl indole, right? This is 2-veratryl indole, and this is, we can say that the compound, that is 23rd number compound is there, right? So this is a compound. Then after that, this 2-veratryl indole will be reacts smoothly at this beta position with Chibbs base derived from the dimethyl amine as well as the formaldehyde. That means if you treat this compound with, that is, formaldehyde CH2O as well as dimethyl amine ME2NH, and in the solvent, that is H2O, that is dioxin as well as the acetic acid, right? So that means this 2-veratryl indole, this 2-veratryl indole will be react smoothly at beta position because this alpha position is blocked, and therefore it will be give react with this formaldehyde as well as this dimethyl amine, and then it gives formation of compound like this. Here is a 5-member ring. Then remaining functionalities will be same, OME, here is aromatic ring, and then it gives formation of this CH2 NME2, right? And if you see, this is a 22 number compound. After that, when this compound, that is this 22 intermediate, will be react with the N-methylation of the dimethyl amine substituted. That means if we are doing N-methylation here, that means if you treat this compound with, that is, methyl iodide, and secondly if you treat this compound with sodium cyanide and DMF, that is dimethyl formamide, then it gives near about a 97% product. That means yield, that is N-methylation, if you treat this amine with this methyl iodide, it gives a quaternary ammonium salt, and then in the second state if you treat the sodium cyanide, then cyanide attack will be takes place here, and then this quaternary ammonium salt will be removed, and it gives a compound like this. So which compound it gives? That means the remaining aromatic ring will be same here, this 5-member ring is again same here, then this ring is also same, that is OME here, here is NH, the aromatic ring is same here, and here it gives attack of this cyanide, right? So that means it gives a intermediate, that is called as a, so this intermediate, and in further step, if we treat this intermediate with reduction, that is using ALAH, lithium aluminum hydride, in presence of solvent, that is THF, and if we heat this compound, then this nitrile will be reduced to form the amine, and then after reduction, what it gives? It gives a amine like this, CH2, and then NH2. That means the reduction of this nitrile group will be takes place at this position, and then remaining functionalities will be same here like this, right? And here is a double bond will be again same. So this gives a intermediate, that is 20, and its name is, that is 2-veratryl tryptamine. Veratrin, tryptamine. So it gives 2 veratrin, tryptamine. Then in further step, if we treat these compound, so these 2 veratrin, tryptamine, when we can treat with this ethyl glyoxamate, then it gives formation of Chief's base. What is ethyl glyoxamate? That means if you treat this compound ethyl glyoxamate, that is CHO, right? And in presence of this benzene as a solvent, it gives a near about 92% yield of the Chief's base. So what is Chief's base? Chief's base, it gives formation of like this. The remaining functionalities will be same here. Here is OME, then OME, here is alpha beta unsubstituted system is there, then CH2, then it will be react with this ethyl glyoxamate and it gives formation of this Chief's base, that is CO2ME. So this is intermediate 19, and this intermediate 19 will be used near about 92% yield of the product. Then in further step, if we treat this compound with a para-tosyl chloride, that means if we treat this compound with para-tosyl chloride in presence of pyridine as a solvent, then it gives near about 64% yield of the compound. And what is the compound? That means it will be, see the mechanism. If you see the mechanism, so this is our compound. So this is a compound, that is Chief's base. In the Chief's base, the functionalities will be here, which is same here. That is OME, OME, OME. And then, so this CH2, then here is nitrogen, and then here is a double bond, and then CO2ME, right? So here is a double bond and this is hydrogen. So what will the pyridine? Pyridine will be take this proton, right? And then, so this bond will be shift here, and then it will be attack on this carbon-carbon double bond, and then it will be combined with the para-tosyl chloride. So here is structure of para-tosyl chloride, and then it will be removed chlorine. And then what it gives? It gives formation of 2 different isomers. What are these 2 different isomers? So when this intermediate 19 will be treated with this para-tosyl chloride, first base will be takes this proton, then it will be attack on this Chief's base, and it gives formation of a ring at this position, and it gives a compound like this, that is aromatic ring is same here, this 5-member ring is same here, this aromatic ring is same here, and only here it gives isomer which containing hydrogen below the plane. So this is called as isomer 18A, along with it gives formation of a isomer, that is which containing this hydrogen which above the plane. Then remaining functionalities will be same here, which containing OME, OME function group is here same. Then so this ring is also same here, it containing NSO2Ar here, then CH2, then so this COOET below the plane and hydrogen above the plane, right? So this isomer is called as a 18B, and we are only interested about this isomer, that is 18B, which can be used for the further synthesis. So friends, with this we can stop here. The remaining parts will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you.